whose mothers can't even come to the game because they can't afford a bus ticket. It makes no sense that you have coaches that are living in $10 million houses and players who have family members that are living in the projects. That if you don't understand that that is a racial issue, as much as it is, it's three issues. It's a financial issue in terms of labor rights. The coaches deserve, the players deserve labor rights. Everybody else, I heard many coaches. Remember, I've taught on college campuses for 25 years. I taught at University of Kentucky, Syracuse University, The Ohio State University. I've been at schools that have big time basketball programs and big time football programs. And the thing is, you don't go to programs like that with your sports being an extracurricular activity. That's all bullshit. There's nothing extracurricular about being a college football player. I had a player when I was at Syracuse University, I got into an argument with a coach one time because there was a player, a quarterback that was in my class. And the first week I get this email from some guy I don't know. And he says, Professor Watkins, so-and-so is going to have to miss your class for the first week because he's got a big game that we're playing out in Utah. And we have to fly out there to get prepared for the game. And I'm like, what the fuck the hell? I'm like, what does that have to do with me? And what does that have to do with his class? You know, you told me that sports is supposed to be extracurricular. If it's extracurricular, then why isn't he playing football games on the weekends? Why isn't he fitting his football schedule into his academic schedule? Why must the academic schedule fit into his football schedule? And I said, next time he has a class he has to meet, I need him to email me directly like the other students. I don't want to hear from his representative. And then I said, also, you ought to be ashamed of the fact that you're keeping this young man from getting an education, because anybody who misses an entire week of my class is probably going to fail. So you're setting him up for failure. You're using him and setting him up for failure. Now, needless to say, they did what any coaching staff would do. They told their players to avoid my class. So a lot of the black players are like, yeah, I want to learn from the one black guy that they decided to hire out of 1,000. But the coaches are like, oh, no, don't take his class. He's going to challenge you intellectually. Because they don't want the black man to be challenged intellectually. They only want you to develop your athletic ability. They don't want you to be smart. They want you to be a big, dumb-ass jock. That's what they want you to be. They want to use you up, chew you up, and spit you out as soon as the money stops flowing. And the money is usually flowing in one direction. It's never flowing into your community. It's never flowing into your family. It's never flowing back to your hood. It's flowing out to the suburbs. And black people, if you want to know why black people struggle in terms of wealth, if you want to know why black wealth, give me a yes or no. Has anybody seen the stat? I want to make sure we all know about the stat. Has anybody seen the stat that says black wealth is expected to drop to zero by 2053? Yes or no? Has anybody seen the stat that says black wealth, median black wealth, is expected to drop to zero by 2053? Has anybody seen that? Give me a yes or no if you've seen this. I want to make sure we're on the same page. Well, there's a stat that says black wealth is expected to drop to zero by 2053. Wealth does not just disappear and go into outer space. Wealth gets transferred. Wealth gets moved around. Black people are not people without wealth. Your wealth comes from your natural resources. One of your most valuable natural resources is the tremendous athletic ability of your young black men and women as well, right? The natural athletic ability of the black community is a multi-trillion dollar commodity, and they come and they scrape it out of the ground and steal it no differently from the way the Chinese go and steal all the wealth out of Africa. The same way the Germans went and set up a castle on the Gold Coast so they could suck out all the slaves, and the British did it and the Dutch did it, and they're sucking out the slaves and the gold and the minerals and the diamonds and the oil. They're taking all this out of your community. So you might think that you ain't got nothing to do with Africa, but this white supremacy thing is a global phenomenon. They are doing the same thing in your neighborhood that they're doing over in South Africa. They're doing the same thing in your community that they're doing in Mozambique and Angola and in Ghana and in Tanzania. They're coming to your neighborhoods and sucking your resources out like leeches. And then you wonder why your wealth is dropping to zero. How in the hell is your wealth dropping to zero when so many people are getting rich off of your natural resources?